face was scanned by police cameras at least twice.
Facial recognition is a uniquely dangerous form of surveillance. The crisis of surveillance and rising surveillance is a crisis for our society. It's a crisis for human rights.
What do you think about facial recognition technology and cameras in general? How dangerous is it?
Surveillance technology broadly has been demonstrated to have a profoundly chilling effect on people's freedom of expression, their ability to speak out and hold powerful people and institutions accountable. But facial recognition makes it almost impossible to make your voice heard in an anonymous fashion, right? The right to show up to a protest to make your voice heard without having your face scanned or your details cataloged should be a fundamental human right in any country that claims to be a democracy. Really demonstrate the way that facial recognition, when used by law enforcement, is essentially the eradication of human privacy and that fundamental liberty or ability to speak out safely. The more necessary protesting becomes, the more dangerous it becomes.
Why is it not banned if it's so dangerous?
I would put the U.S. in, certainly right now, but also historically, I think should be seen as an authoritarian country broadly, and a, you know, with a government that has exhibited authoritarian impulses throughout history. Fight that we're fighting right now in the U.S. and I think globally around facial recognition. One is with law enforcement and intelligence agencies who want to use this technology to track people, to monitor them, to suppress protests and uprisings, but also target immigrant communities, minority communities, Black and brown communities who are disproportionately impacted by this technology. Then the second prong of the fight is with corporations who stand to make a lot of money by selling this technology, not only to law enforcement, but they're trying to push it for all kinds of things, from taking attendance in schools to entry and exit to events. I would argue that commercial use and spread of facial recognition is just as dangerous as government and law enforcement use of this technology. There are profoundly discriminatory and abusive ways that private companies can use this technology that put people's lives at risk, that put people in danger or subject them to discrimination. Just banning government or law enforcement use of facial recognition would certainly prevent a lot of the worst types of harms that can come from this technology, but it would be leaving us vulnerable to profound levels of abuse.
How are we not secure maybe in our home environment? Can you comment more on that?
At a baseline level, I would encourage anyone to recognize that any device that is connected to the internet and collecting any kind of data on you is essentially a surveillance device and can be used to collect data about you that might reveal more than you would expect. Even just basic habits like when you're at home and when you're not, when you sleep, when you don't, how often you go to the bathroom. The more that we kind of plug in our lives, the more quote unquote smart things we have in our homes, whether it's a refrigerator or a doorbell, the more data is being collected about us and stored. And in the end, you're trusting those companies essentially to protect that data. I actually basically strongly encourage folks that, like, old school, locking your door is gonna make you and your family safer than putting an internet connected camera on your front door that could reveal a lot of details and information about your family without your knowledge or consent. So I do think we need to recognize, we often think of surveillance as something that's imposed upon us by an autocratic government. But in many ways, we are becoming willing participants. We're purchasing the surveillance devices that will be used to monitor us in the future. You know, if we are purchasing these devices, surrounding ourselves with devices that are watching and listening to us, we're essentially laying the groundwork for a future police state.
So besides what you just said, what would their advices, from you for the people who want to speak up, want to go to the protests, want to organize themselves and be not afraid, of being caught for not even doing a crime, especially when we know that, like, facial recognition cameras are inaccurate when it comes to the people of color and so on. So what are the basic advice? So
first thing I would say is don't stop protesting. You know, the whole purpose of surveillance is to make us feel too afraid to go out in the streets and make our voices heard. And so if we allow that to control us, then we're almost surrendering to not just the surveillance, but to the injustice and the corruption that fuels it. That said, I think also just recognizing that there are practical steps that you can take to protect yourself and make yourself a bit safer. But there's also, I think it's important to recognize that often, you know, facial recognition is a relatively new addition to the arsenal of law enforcement, but they've already for many years had access to things like tracking cell phone location data or other things like that, that are actually fairly easy to address, you know, by just taking a few steps on your phone. We're often taught to believe that there's nothing we can do, or that the government is sort of all-seeing and all-knowing, and you know, we just have to accept that. But the reality is there are simple things that you can do by just, you know, putting a good password on your phone, using you know, an encrypted messaging app like Signal or WhatsApp or iMessage instead of regular SMS messages, and you know, not using thumbprint or Face ID on your phone, because a police officer or someone else could force you to unlock your phone in a way that would be much more difficult with a strong password. And so I think we need to approach surveillance self-defense as sort of a harm reduction, as opposed to all or nothing. But you know, just taking those basic steps of a good password and using an encrypted messaging app, you're already way better off than you would have been if you didn't take those steps.
Okay, Evan, so it was really nice talking to you. Thank you.
Thanks for having me.
Time.
Yeah, good to chat.
Bye.